Hi everyone, it's this year and I'm sharing a custom order journal that I made with the ephemera embellishment pack that I've been making. And at the end of the video, I'll also be showing you how I would use some of the pieces here in my own work. So Anne, I hope you love it. Anne wanted me to make her the shabby chic style kit that I had made before. And I mentioned to her that I may have some of the pieces as I did previously to add to it, but each kit is unique, so I can't always have the same pieces. Again, I used a paper bag from J9 Scrap Shop in the gorgeous image on the front. I'll list everything below of all the digitals I've used as well. Now, she wanted a shabby chic style, and so I'm trying to kind of do something similar. I love making these mini journals, but I did mention to her that may not have all the pieces that I had before. This is a J9 Scraps bag. I found this gorgeous image in the Daphne Starry magazine that I felt really well with the colors that I'm using. Again, I've sprayed some of the pages and coffee stained some others. This is the wallpaper page that I've used. Look at this gorgeous butterfly that I added to the brand there. And as you can see, I've kept the journal like the other ones, just easy to embellish yourself, add things to it, write in it, add pictures, etc. She also mentioned that she loves adding her own pieces to the journals I make, so it makes me so happy to know that she's enjoying my work so much. So thank you so much, Anne. I will be adding additional pieces to this kit as well, because I just like to add little extras here and there as I'm packaging them up. So this is just, I added actually a little lined paper that's hard to journal on, and then that gorgeous postcard there. So the ephemera kit that I made as well comes in the vintage doily, fabric doily that I'm making the little pouches out of. I love these little pouches. Here I've got a couple of pieces, like the jeweler's envelope that I've collaged on. This is a J9 Scraps envelope. Vintage wallpaper stitched pocket that I made. It's got a little piece of ephemera in it. These are the floating pockets. A bookmark that I've also done a little bit of collaging on. Just love how these feel. And this one I used a guest check, and I've also added the gorgeous image there with the vintage transparency. And then for the envelope pocket, I also found some gorgeous images for the shabby chic style that she wanted. Layerweight tag with the pin from J9 Scrap Shop, and a little envelope for the bottom pocket there that I had. And then I also have the other tag with the vintage print there, and that's vintage wallpaper and the vintage trim at the top. So this is kind of like a whole vintage tag there. So Anne, I hope you love it. It's ready to go. For the rest of you, if you want to stay tuned to see how I'm putting it together and how I use some of the pieces in my work, I'll show you that next. So I'm just going to be showing you how to use some of the ephemera pieces that I've made in one of my journals. So for example, I'll start with the wallpaper pocket. Now I'm using a traveler's notebook to show you, but if you had a larger journal, this could be positioned a different way. You can always just attach it to any kind of end of the page to make a little tuck spot in the back. You could paper clip it, and if it's a larger journal, you would flip it over and make it into a nice pocket. For the guest check, the same thing. It could just be attached in one corner to make a tuck spot in the back. And then also alternatively, this one can be paper clipped anywhere. There is space to journal in the back, but I think it just makes a gorgeous accent to any work. The jeweler's envelope would be the same thing. This would add an additional pocket to a page, inside the envelope, of course, and also the back of it, depending on how you glue it together. It could be the side or the top. And then the envelope pocket, same thing, just adding more pockets to your work. You could have an additional pocket in the back, depending on how that is glued together. So then you would have four pockets, one in the back, and then the other three that I've made with it. So, that can be in the front, it can be in the back, it can be anywhere in your journal, or you can just keep it on its own. These would also be nice to do a snail mail or happy mail to friends. Oh my gosh, I love the idea of getting some of these little things together. I do have a bookmark sometimes that I add to them if I can find the extra piece there. So this becomes a bookmark or a tuck spot, which I really love as well. And so it's just kind of versatile that way that you can use it in so many ways, like I said, on its own or added to your own work. So I hope this gave you some ideas. I know some people were asking me on how I would use these pieces. Thank you for joining me. I will see you soon. And comments, please leave below. Bye.